Jenny. Hiding place in the Luxembourg Gardens. I should keep looking.
Athanase, pour l'amour de Dieu, run and hide!
What do you mean, Papa?
Hurry, I beg you! The Count is at our door! He shall take us away!
Good heavens!
Don't worry about me. Run, I say. Run!
hiding place in the Luxembourg Gardens. If I could find out where it was, I could track Athenaeus.
Thank you.
Monsieur Necker.
Madame? Eh bien, do you come bearing good news?
Your wife. You may rest easy, monsieur. Your wife escaped the massacre. She returned home and left you this letter.
Mon Dieu. She's going to meet our daughter and son-in-law at our charity hospital.
She may already be there.
Madame, I did not dare to dream of such an outcome. My wife and daughter. Can you imagine? And I thought I had lost both of them. The three of us will be able to leave the kingdom and put these horrors behind us forever.
What about the bonds?
They're not in your possession.
No, not yet.
You must ensure they do not benefit the king, madame. You will find them in the Armoire de Fer, in the Palais des Tuileries. Do with them as you see fit. As long as the king does not use them. As for me, I'm going to find my family at once. Thank you. From the bottom of my heart. I pray that your efforts will be successful. Adieu, madame. Adieu.
Minister Necker has given his bonds to me.
That's quite a nice little sum. Can you imagine? That's one-fifth of the kingdom's entire wealth.
Wealth that the king squanders for his personal benefit according to his whims.
Ma foi. Monsieur Necker certainly has been very generous to his adoptive country.
Generous? I have my doubts. The loan was granted at a very high rate. So high, in fact, that it would have dug the deficit into an even deeper state of abyss.
Eh bien, monsieur. To what use shall we employ this boonful fortune?
If I could spend it, I'd do everything I could to return to the people their confiscated freedom. To begin, I would get them the bread they so sorely need. It is only after the scourge of famine has been vanquished that armed patriots might then be able to rise up against despotism.
And where will you find wheat, Robespierre? Will you steal it from under the noses of the automats who have sworn to destroy the human race? As for arming the people, this is another one of your delusions. How could your ragged pack of wretches win any sort of battle that be unable to lift a sword?
When you insult the people, you insult me, Monsieur de Lafayette.
I am not insulting anyone, Robespierre. But I happen to know what it takes to fight. Unlike you. Monsieur, I was but a lad of 15 when I took up arms. And everyone here knows my role in the liberation of America from British rule. If you allow me to dispose of these bonds, I will found an army that will annihilate the Clockwork King's diabolical machines. As soon as I have the opportunity to leave Paris, I will rally the officers and troops that are stationed in the provinces. Then, I will call for a mass uprising. I will have more than enough money to pay their wages and procure the weapons we need.
And you will have obedient troops at your beck and call, ready to repress anyone who challenges your power.
These troops will only serve the will of the people. I swear it.
Are you sure that the king has spared the rest of the kingdom, Monsieur le Marquis?
I am almost certain of it, mon père. Despite all of his resources, the king does not have enough manpower to occupy all the garrisons in the country.
Aegis, no member of this assembly can force your hand. The choice is yours. To whom will you entrust Monsieur Necker's bonds?
The bonds are not yet in my possession.
Then please continue your search.
Athanasius' hiding place. A fight took place here. Franciscus Antonius. What unusual names. Whose cane could this be? Perhaps the guests at the Cordelier can enlighten me. Monsieur Lavoisier.
What can I do for you, Aegis?
Did the names Franciscus Antonius mean anything to you?
No, nothing really.
François Antoine, maybe?
No, nothing with that name either. I'm sorry, madame.
Goodbye, Monsieur Lavoisier. Monsieur Lavoisier.
What can I do for you, Aegis?
The clues I found at the warehouse suggest that the gunpowder was moved to the Bastille.
Diable! You must find a way to get there and put an end to this threat.
Where can I obtain some...
I can't... You should ask my... He uses...
Goodbye, Monsieur Le... Monsieur Bailly. Does the name Franciscus Antonius mean anything to you?
We scholars have the strange habit of adopting names from antiquity. I imagine that we're actually looking for someone named François Antoine. But no matter how hard I think, I'm afraid it doesn't ring a bell.
Monsieur Bailly. Goodbye, Miss...
So how is Monsieur Marat?
I haven't met him yet.
He is your only chance to reach the Bastille, Aegis. You must speak to him. He's holed up in the quarries of Montmartre, hiding from the Marquis de Lafayette.
I found a cane engraved with the name Franciscus Antonius. Who could it belong to?
Let me think a moment, je vous prie. I know an Antoine François. A printer on Rue de la Harpe. His surname is Momoro, but he is a man of the people and a true patriot. I doubt that he ever sported a cane with his name engraved on it.
Were you present when the Estates General was dissolved?
Oui, madame. I had a front row seat. I witnessed what it cost to defy the crown. We laid bare before the king the abject misery of his subjects. It was more than he could suffer. So he had the people's representatives dispersed by means of bayonets. At least we only had to contend with soldiers made of flesh and blood, positively angelic compared to the machines that have swept through Paris.
Goodbye, Monsieur de Robespierre.
Did you go to the Hotel de Massiac?
No, not yet.
Remember, It's by Les Halles, just west of the Marché des Innocents.
I found a cane inscribed with the name Franciscus Antonius. Does that mean anything to you?
No. I'm sorry.
Monseigneur.
What can I do for you, Ashes?
Do the four names Franciscus Antonius mean anything to you?
The Franciscan Order, perhaps?
Go on.
Franciscus Assisiensis, the founder of the Order, and Antonius Patavinus, one of its most illustrious members. I'm sorry, Aegis, but that's all I can think of.
How is your research on Nicholas Flamel going?
I have done nothing yet.
Don't take too long, Aegis. Don't forget that the tomb is in the crypt of the Église Saint-Jacques de la Boucherie, under the cemetery. The church isn't far from the Hôtel de Ville.
Franciscus Antonius. Does that mean anything to you?
Let's see. François Antoine. No, that doesn't mean anything to me, I'm afraid. Désolé, ma chère.
Goodbye, mon père. Monsieur le Marquis.
I'm listening, Aegis.
Franciscus Antonius. Do these names mean anything specific to you?
François Antoine. Hold on. Of course. That's the master arquebusier who killed the beast of Gévaudan. The affair took place during the reign of Louis the Beloved, just a few leagues from the castle where I grew up. I was still a young boy, but I remember it like it was yesterday. It caused a stir all over the country.
I doubt that it has anything to do with my case.
I don't know. I'll let you be the judge of that.
So how is Monsieur Marat?
I haven't met him yet.
He is your only chance to reach his hold up in...
Goodbye, Miss... Monsieur Lavoisier.
What can I do?
Goodbye, Miss... Monsieur Bailly. Goodbye...
Did you go to the hotel?
No.
Remember.
See you later. Monseigneur.
What can I do for you?
Goodbye.
Allez, en paix.
How is your research on...
I have done nothing.
Don't take too long. Don't forget that the church isn't...
Goodbye. Monsieur le Marquis.
I'm listening.
Goodbye. Here I am at an impasse. Should I go to the Tuileries to examine the safe? There may be a way to force it open. I can get to the Tuileries Palace via the Louvre. Then I should be able to enter it through the courtyard.
Thank you.
The lock wasn't forced. Whoever opened it had the key. Monsieur Necker's bonds are still there. There's something engraved on it. H.G. Riquetti. Comte de Mirabeau. Whoever broke into this safe left behind the most valuable thing in it. This doesn't make sense.
Come on.